Wait, you think these calls aren't monitored? You are the government.
Oh, I thought you meant, like...
No, Stephanie, I don't care how much they know, how much of a gun-toting, crazy wingnut they think you are. Lady, do you think we got sleep after last night?
I'm awake. What's your problem?
Our problem.
Sorry, our problem.
That storm knocked out the phone line I used to talk to the service, which means we're cut off. I tried radioing out, and that's not working
either. So we're out here alone.
I don't really know why that would be the case.
There's no backup?
The backup is the two-day hike out of here.
So, that's a no?
It's easier for me to send all the lookouts out to check the status of the wire in their areas. Yours is a good hike away. If you find any portion of it down, I can try to get a hold of a ranger, and he'll bring someone in to fix it.
Okay, I can do that. Where is it?
Remember that cave you hiked through yesterday?
Yeah, of course.
So, you're gonna want to go back there, go through it, and keep going straight to the north when you come out.
Will do.
Thanks, Hank.
It's Henry.
What, you don't like Hank?
Yeah, I don't like Hank.
But thanks rhymes with Hank.
No, it doesn't.
If you said, thank Hank, then maybe we wouldn't have this problem. Like, thank God, thank Hank.
But who's Hank?
What?
Who's Hank? Why are we thanking Hank?
Henry, Hank. Steph, they go together like... You know how sometimes people call William will call Bill?
Yeah.
Same thing.
I believe what you were referring to is a nickname.
Stephanie, I will force feed you this soda can.
I'm not gonna touch that with a 10-foot pole. Splunking back down the mountain. Splunking?
Fallen tree.
Ooh, a wind last night actually tore up some trees near my tower.
I know, right? Ugh, it's out of this world. Now, imagine we had a big fire burning.
Yeah. Jesus.
It's something else. I've seen a still evening kick up 45-mile-an-hour winds in no time. That happens this summer, you'll really be in.
Yay!
Very comforting, Delilah.
That happy thought.
Very comforting. Where the hell Oh, there it is.
Yeah, I thought I...
Oh, I don't like that.
No, that's all bad. That's definitely not gonna break a leg.
Well, if he... I'm just saying, if he takes that fall wrong, you know? Mm-hmm. I'd be extra leery after what happened with that damn shale slide. Remember?
Yeah, also, when you're just alone outdoors, maybe...
Oh, it's actually pretty damn cold out here.
Roger that. Warms up fast. The mornings are cold in Boulder, though, right?
Yeah, they are.
What did you get up to down there? I mean, what's life like?
Wow, you talked to the dog. What a shock.
I used to just spend a lot of time with our dog, Bucket.
Aw, that's a good name.
He was a good dog.
What type?
A beagle. We got him from the pound.
That's great. Hey, can you hold on a sec?
Sure. Just gonna keep hiking and hoping it warms up.
Heyo. I don't think so. Why, have you? Okay, good. No, I don't think he has any idea.
Relax, it's nothing, I'm sure.
I'm absolutely sure. Would you?
Wait, I thought her phone line was down.
All right, I'll let you know if anything changes in that regard. Hey, sorry about that. Anyway, Bucket's a cute name. You owned him with someone?
No,
Who was that?
Who was who?
I don't think
he has any idea. What was that? Were you talking about me?
What?
You left your button pressed or something.
Henry, that call was work. I was just talking to... Actually, it's not really your business. Why are you freaking out?
I'm not freaking out.
Good. So I'm gonna go quiet for a little bit. Call
you annoyed her. Way to go.
I seem to do that to people.
Yeah, a lot.
I meant to say something about Julia, but...
You pressed the wrong thing.
My fingers slipped.
Ah, yeah, sure. Anyway, we're going the right way. This place is smaller than it looks. I get the feeling.
Go for a nice...
Shut up, Crow.
You know, barreling through the underbrush and the forest out in the wild just kind of seems like a bad idea.
Unless you're a grizzly bear.
Yeah, which is why it's a bad idea.
Oh, right.
I'm just going to push through these bushes. More! Dead.
I read a story about a guy who killed a bear with his bare hands. Or did he use a pocket knife? Yeah, basically the same thing.
I wouldn't want to fight a bear with a pocket knife.
Yeah, you'd lose. You're not him. Seriously, the guy, his whole face was gone.
As happens when you decide to fist fight a bear.
Yeah, but reconstructive surgery put him right back together. That was a badass. Anyway, back on topic. Let's see. I actually prefer these more washed out tones. I'm just more of a misty morning kind of guy.
It is pretty.
Yeah. There's not really like glare.
Happy little trees.
Bob Ross.
Hey. Do not insult his bobbishness.
I'm not.
I can see the wire you're talking about. It looks like it's in good shape from here.
We'll follow it up to the top of the trail if you can. You can head back as soon as you give me the all clear.
Now, wasn't she just talking on the phone?
You saw that too, right?
What?
Oh, there it is.
Oh, it's her tower over there.
Stephanie! There it is.
Hey, I can see your tower. Suppose that means you can see me.
Yeah, well enough.
Can you see the communication wires from where you are?
I can see the poles, but I have no idea if the wire is in good shape or not. They run a good distance up to a spot called Beartooth Point. You just need to walk along them all the way up there and make sure everything's in ship shape.
Easy enough. You got lost.
It's not getting lost if I didn't know where I was going to begin with.
So then you were just meandering.
Pretty much.
Botanist would have a field day out here. A literal field day. A day in a field. This sounds a field. This seems too rocky.
Yeah. This is... What would you call this? It's really not...
Not mountainous. This almost looks like a quarry.
An outcrop?
Doesn't matter. He's got it. Yeah, oh, wait. It's her. Are we going?
There's something over here I want to get.
It's up where you can't get at it, though. Oh, it's another box.
Can't get at it, huh?
Well, yeah, I don't think so from down here.
Hmm.
Or maybe I'm mistaken.
Oh, yes, little Faith.
I don't work on Faith. Seems like a bad policy. One, two, three, four. It's literally the simplest thing in the world next to 1111.
You said that.
I know, but there's repeating.
A note?
Look, another note.
Oh. Dave. Yes.
Should we call this one in too?
Yeah, well, in just a minute. Heyo, I got your note about needing to talk, and sorry I didn't track you down. Been looking for you all day. Figured you'd be out near the canyon helping with grad students, but I guess not. I don't even know how I could really help anyway. We're co-workers, you know? Amigos profesionales.
Professionales? God, but the effort into a sister, come on.
No. If you need something, if you need someone to throw a case back
with and go time traveling, Ron's your guy. But I'm not great with the life stuff. You get it? You get it.
Okay.
Hey, who are these guys, Ron and Dave? They're leaving notes for each other in the boxes. Is there any chance one of them was that guy I saw in the canyon? You know, the guy with the flashlight?
No, they're both rangers. They're not out here this season. I didn't really know them that well, but I always assumed the only thing Ron cared about was chasing tail and getting loaded. It's somehow comforting to know that he was able to keep up a correspondence with someone who wasn't going to send him a
text. He might. You don't know.
I don't judge their relationship. Rude. Some dime store murder thriller.
Yep. Be gone! So I think we probably need to go down that way.
What's on that rock?
Huh?
That rock over there. No. To the left. To the left. On the that. Over there, on that rock. Down, sister. Down. Look down.
Oh!
Oh, a turtle!
Whoa, I found a turtle. Maybe it's a tortoise. It's a thing with a shell.
Well, isn't that something?
It's actually pretty cute.
Embrace tortoise.
Well, Henry, if you decide you want it to keep you company, nobody will mind.
Now, what do I call it? Looks like a...
Turt Reynolds!
Oh, this ought to be good.
Turt Reynolds.
Well, now we're taking you with us.
Baby!
Is impressive. Ah.
You tell him I love Cannonball Run.
It's so little.
Adopt! Adopt! Immediately!
Yes. Love turds achievement. Oh, love turds. Like love turds. But it's a turd.
The child has been acquired. Our family is restored! Turtles and tortoises can live for a very long time.
I believe that was actually a tortoise, but what do I mean?
We must love and embrace him. Or
I am not the
we
herpetologist.
We have not actually established that yet.
I am not the herpetologist. I do not study herps.
It's a baby.
It's small.
We must never abandon it. Her,
it's
him.
It's small and must protect.
Yes. I fear our soul is in danger.
Yeah, I didn't have one to begin with, so I'm not worried.
Well, yeah, I know, but I gotta worry about myself, you know? And what the hell are those?
Those would be beer cans.
Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, report this.
Guess what?
What is it?
There's a bunch of empty cans up here.
Same as before?
Yep.
These fucking kids.
How could these girls be so stupid?
Trust me, I never underestimate the stupidity of a drunk teenager. Also, I never underestimate the balls of a drunk young woman, having been one.
I can vouch for that.
So we really can't reach anyone any other way than these wires?
What else do you suggest? Smoke signals?
Just seems dangerous.
Well, if they don't hear from me for a few days, they'll send someone out, but I'd rather it not come to that.
These girls are really just chugging.
Okay, the wire's down here.
Okay, good. Any sign of those girls? Did they mess with anything?
I'll look around.
Yep.
Oh, no. They wouldn't.
Hey, so the wire is definitely down out here. I just found it. Yeah, the thing is, it doesn't look like the wind. It looks like it was cut deliberately.
This should say go to hell.
Like the moment you said you found their trash.
Oh, it's panties.
These idiots are gonna pay. Ooh. Do they realize this is how people die? I mean, what if something happened to one of my lookouts while this was going on? And God forbid there's an actual fire burning out of control.
What do you want to do?
I want you to go find them.
And then what?
I haven't thought that far ahead. That's not true. Everything I come to find is illegal.
Let's hear it.
Oh, yeah?
Hey, I came out here for a breath of fresh air and some adventure. What do you got?
I think I want you to just find them and scare the hell out of them.
Yeah, I'd make a spooky ghost costume, but they stole my sheets.
I don't know. Wait for them to wander off and wreck their camp. Something that would make a teenage girl run home to mommy and daddy.
I'll find them.
Thanks.
But I'm gonna need a raise.
Don't hold your breath. I'd start by hiking back towards your tower and just keep an eye
out
for anything that would lead you to
them.
Another big into Red Eagle.
Great. See if you can find the path they took down from there. Maybe they looped back around towards the lake or something. I doubt they're where they were yesterday, but they obviously can't have gone far.
I want to know how two naked drunk teenagers managed to beat me both here and back to my lookout tower without me seeing them.